Okay, so let's look at the designing of full subtractor using NAND gate, which is our first universal gate. Okay, so this is the arrangement given to you. So since in the difference output we have A XOR B XOR BI, which is similar to what we had in full adder also, A XOR B XOR carry input. So the structure will be same for difference as well. Okay, so you can see these four guys, arrangement of four guys will give you the XOR of the inputs. A XOR B, here you are getting. Similarly, this four arrangement, which is copy of this, will give you XOR of the two inputs. So here the input is A XOR B, and here the input is BI. Okay, so A XOR B XOR BI. This is what you are getting. So this is similar to what we had in full adder. Now, how are we gonna get the borrow output? So this is how you will get the black one. You can see. You will take this point, you will take this point, both of them use a NAND gate, and you will get a borrow output. Okay, so I'll explain you what are these points. Okay, so let's look at this guy. So this here, if you look at this, it is A dot B bar NAND gate output. So this output will be A dot B bar, which is this input dot B whole bar. Now let's open this. You'll get A bar plus B bar dot B whole bar. Now multiply B inside, so you will get A bar B plus B bar B whole bar. So this will be zero, right? So what you will get ultimately is A bar B whole bar. Okay, so this is this position. So I'll write here A bar B whole bar. Okay, this is what you are getting here. Now let me use this position. So what will be the output here? It will be A XOR B dot BI bar this output. So A XOR B dot BI bar. Okay, this is this position. What is this position? BI. So I'll take product BI and take bar of whole bar. Okay, this will be the output here. So let's open this bar. So you'll get A XOR B bar plus BI bar into BI whole bar. If I'll multiply inside BI, this and this multiplied will give you 0. So what is remaining is A XOR B bar BI whole bar, right? So this is the output here. I'll write A XOR B whole bar BI. Okay, like this is same, right? So now I can remove this. Explanation is done. Now you will see it's a borrow output expression or second expression. Okay, so if I'll do the BI plus 1, it will be A bar B whole bar dot this term A XOR B bar BI whole bar double bar, right? This is how it works. This is the first input. This is the second input. NAND you have taken. Use the De Morgan's law. So A bar B, this is double bar will cancel, plus A XOR B bar BI. And you can see this is the second expression of borrow input plus 1. So that is how it satisfies the expression of borrow output. Okay. So hopefully the explanation is clear to you. Just take two leads from the existing circuit and use an AND gate, and you will get the borrow. Okay. So that is how you will use NAND gate for difference and borrow output. Now, how many are being used? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Total 8 has NAND has been used for difference, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 also. So totally you can say 9 we are using. 8, 9 NAND gates are used to make difference and borrow. Now individually, if you want to see how many we are making for we are using for difference and borrow, so you will see that this output will be generated after 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, after 8 NAND gate. Okay, so for difference we require 8 NAND gates, and for borrow output we require, what inputs we require? This input we want and this input we want. This input we will get after these two. Okay, so 2 3 4, for this guy I have to go till here, right? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. Okay, total 7 will be required NAND gates to make this borrow output. And if you will talk in terms of propagation delay, let's TPD is the propagation delay of all the NAND gates. So how much propagation delay for difference? So this will be 1, so this output will be after 1 TPD, then these two will generate output at the same time. Okay, but they both have the propagation delay same, as well as the input is getting generated at the same time, so they both will take same time to generate the output. So TPD, these two will generate 2 TBT. Okay, they would, you won't take separately for these two, they both will generate output at the same time. So TPD plus TPD from these two guys, then TPD from this guy, then this guy, plus TPD, then these two guys will again generate at the same time. So plus TPD, then plus TPD, 3 4 5 6, total 6 are there. Okay, so 6 TPD it takes. Now let's take for borrow output, how much it will take? 1 2 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, till here we want, we don't want this guy for borrow output, so 6 TPD. So 1 2 3 4 5, and then this guy 6. Okay, so we don't have to, the catch is we don't have to take TPD separately for these two guys, they are having same input, they are having input at the same time, and their propagation delay is also same, that is why the output will be generated at the same time. Okay, this is available, this is already available, and when the output of this guy will be generated, so input for both the NAND gates will be available at the same time, and because they have both same propagation delay, the output will be generated at the same time. That's why I've only taken 1 TPD. Okay, so this is also, although it is not so required right now, but still I wanted to cover just in case if you are dealing with time and all, which is very important. So let's look at the same thing with NOR gate.